All right, everybody. Here we go. Uh-oh. Well, crap. Dude. Look how ridiculous. Let's play. Another guy has way more better people than me, of course. I don't know. See how it goes.
Set to go now is the rookie second round pick, Roberto Aguayo. And we are underway in Foxborough. And on the return, here comes Adam Jones. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line.
Well, see how this goes.
The first carry now for Todd Gurley.
Ah, come on. Ah, man. That was terrible. It's a freaking terrible. There, bringing up
second. Muhammad Wilkerson elevated a Temple program that was looking for players like him, and he's carried that into the NFL. What a terrific play there.
A nice tackle for loss for the former Temple Owl, as you said, and the 30th pick in the 2011 draft.
You, oh my god, I had him wide open. Dude, are you freaking serious? I hate stupid plays like that. Come on.
Third and long, it's Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep.
No, dude! Come on! Dude, I had him over. Oh my god! You gotta be kidding me! They were going to be aggressive and push the ball down. What the heck was that? My god, that makes me mad. Oh, he dropped it. Nice.
Jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On play action, they'll throw. He's got time in the pocket. He's got
Darn it. Of course, a freaking course. Yeah, of course I said timeout. Of course.
Back to throw now on first down. Looking left side, he's got it complete. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. The four-time Pro Bowler Herman Moore, his first grab of the game.
Led the league in receptions twice. And just think about, he was the game plan when you had to line up against Detroit. Circle him, find a way to stop him, and rarely did teams get that done.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. And that is caught.
Great.
He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. And his kick is right through. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. Now Jones.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Yeah, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better. Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. Now he's going to let it go deep right sideline.
Ah!
Couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Darn it.
And on second and 10 now.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt. You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only
Come on!
It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. The Bengals getting set to go. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Back to throw here.
Yes, there we go. Nice. All right, got that back.
Big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception.
No, I. Oh, hate when that happens.
Just throw that out the window.
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Come on, man.
How they attack him here. Owen Daniels, the veteran tight end, was the intended target, and now it's third down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
On third down, Wilson.
Oh my God!
He was looking for his tight end, Owen Daniels, and it brings up fourth down. Here's Spencer Lanning now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Beckham, the return. It's a 49-yard punt, but subtract 9 there for the return. And the Bengals take possession. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack.
Brandon, so often we talk about whether or not a quarterback was surprised by the pressure, by the blitz. Most of the time, they're not surprised by that, but the speed in which someone gets there. And on this play, I don't think he had any other chance.
Dang it.
Are they taught in that situation just to tuck it and go down?
Yeah, when you don't even have an opportunity to look downfield and assess what's going on, cover it, take care of the football. Don't turn something bad into something worse.
And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on 3rd and 9. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Oh, he caught the dude! None of my guys can catch it, but he can catch that? Really? Oh my God. Come on. That was stupid.
When he throws it with that much force, one of the best arms the game has ever seen, one of the strongest ones. It does leave a mark. They actually called it the Elway cross because you could see the imprint on a player after he caught one of those bullet passes.
Let's start to throw now on first down. Out to the left here to Reed. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
He'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. LeSean McCoy from 6 yards away. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that 3 and out on the last possession, it told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. On first down, Wilson. It's caught right side by Daniels. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. On second down, Wilson. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field.
Oh my God, dude. Throw the ball. I freaking swear. What is this game? Come on.
Second down. Looking deep for Crabtree.
Yes! Thank you.
A good pick up there. 26 yards.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
There's a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
It's caught by Mike Evans. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
To throw again is Wilson. Polluting the pressure right.
Darn it. Come on.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Oh, I'm tired of it, man. Come on. No time to freaking throw the ball.
And they're going to speed things up here. On third and goal, Wilson. Flush to his right.
Thank you.
Patriot touchdown. Owen Daniels, as the first half is winding down, and the Patriots have cut it back within a score.
Yeah, yeah, you heard it right. Exhale the exhale, and I'm taking that from their bench because finally, right before the half, they find a way to get the ball in the end zone and get some points on the board. Maybe they can use that.
Unfortunately, they're getting the ball back.
To get something before going into the lockers. And now in the second half, they can just tighten.
It's what they want to do. Tighten down everything they're doing, and it maybe explode at the right time.
Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out.
There we go.
Escape, and he goes down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Looking to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And is this
intercepted? There we go.
It's intercepted. Picked off by Nickell Roby. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be...
I don't have much time to do anything else.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now it's Wilson. He's going to look deep down the field. And this one is incomplete. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three.
Try to have a better half here.
Fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in the game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt.
Dang.
Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn them a fresh set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Gun. They'll look to throw, and he's got his man on the out route. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll bring up second down. So another catch for Herman Moore, and back in his day, he was a volume receiver. He still is, I guess.
He had no doubt about it. What'd he have, over 100 catches three different times in the league? That's pretty impressive.
Still holds the franchise mark with 123 catches way back in 95. He'll drop to throw.
Whew, that's close.
Shot, couldn't connect.
Looks like a nickel set here defensively on third and two.
Yeah, maybe expecting a throw. Now back to throw. It goes as a gain of 8. It moves the chains.
Well, we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Show some confidence. Supreme confidence.
Yes.
No escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Khalil Mack not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Now they'll
throw here, out of the gun. Nah. Dang it. Odell Beckham Jr. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Odell Beckham, 58 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead. And this one through the uprights and good. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. Now Jones. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Patriots offensive unit. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Wilson. Over the middle to Evans. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. It's caught right side by Daniels. Give him 16 on the pickup, and that's good for a New England first down. The one running back is Gurley. On first down, Wilson. Wheaton with a catch right side.
Just a one-yard
pickup on the play, and that'll make this a second down. 9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. Again, Wilson. And he finds a man with a crossing route.
Nice.
And he's brought down. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. Throwing again here, Wilson.
Ah!
Pass falls incomplete. Michael Crabtree, intended receiver, and now it's fourth down. Now Chandler Catanzaro for the field goal here, and this will be a 45-yard attempt. And Catanzaro's kick is right through, and that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. Back now in Foxborough, where the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And out now, here come the Bengals. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive. They'll look to throw. And a reception made by Alshon Jeffrey. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Oh!
Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
On second down, it's McCoy. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now. They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
Good call.
He's got it.
And he'll have man. The first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
They go back to the ground with McCoy. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And he'll check this one down to McCoy. Now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And Aguayo able to knock it through. And that will get the lead up to 14. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give him some breathing room and lets him build up a little cushion.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position
right.
They're in.
Let's go. Hurry up.
See if they can get the score. And quickly, they get to the line. On second down, Wilson. It's caught right side by Daniels. And he's brought down after a good game.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere. In the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter because he has such great...
No!
And that should do it. Picked off by the free safety.
Dang it, man. Come on. What is this crap? Really? Oh, my God. That was stupid.
Last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
He'll look to throw. And Reed with it over the middle. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your
Well, I couldn't do anything on defensive side. Well, and the offensive side.
More pressure towards the quarterback.
Darn it.
And still try and cover downfield.
Well, Charles, there's an old saying, don't let a loss beat you twice.
You're exactly right about that, Brandon. When you look at it and all of your preparation went into winning this week, now you have to absorb a loss and find a way to shake it off.
Man, that last interception really sucked. Well, plus that first half, too. I kept missing crap. Ugh. Dang it. Breaking. Dang it. Alright, I don't want to watch anymore.
For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.
Dang, act.
We say so. Ugh. From Foxborough.